इलस्ट्रेशन नंबर 12, इन्फोवे लिमिटेड इज कंसिडरिंग द परचेस ऑफ अ ऑटोमेटिक पैक मशीन, ओके, टू रिप्लेस द टू मशीन विच हैज विच आर करंटली यूज टू पैक अ प्रोडक्ट एक्स. ओके, सो रिप्लेसमेंट वाला टाइप क्वेश्चन है. द मशीन वुड रिजल्ट इन रिड्यूस ऑफ अ लेबर कॉस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ अ मोर ऑटोमेटेड नेचर ऑफ द प्रोसेस एंड इन एडिशन वुड परमिट अ प्रोडक्शन लेवल टू बी इंक्रीज बाय क्रिएटिंग अ ग्रेटर कैपेसिटी. ओके, एट द पैकेजिंग स्टेज with an anticipated rise in a demand for the product. Okay, it has been estimated that the new product will lead to the increase in the profit in each 3 years. Due to uncertainty in demand, however, the annual cash flow including saving resulting from purchase of a new machine cannot be fixed with a certainty and have therefore been estimated probability as follows. Okay, so basically here annual cost flow, it should be actually annual cash flow. Okay, so annual cash flow is given, after that probability is given. Okay, because of the overall uncertainty in the sales of the product, it has been decided that only 3 years cash flow will be considered in deciding whether to purchase the machine. After allowing the scrap value of the existing machine, the net cash net cost of the machine will be 42,000. Okay, so these are not actually a cost flows, these are the cash flows. Okay, so you can change here, and this is basically cost of machine. Okay, so this is outflow and these are inflows. Okay, the effect of taxation should be ignored. Okay, year 1, year 2, year 3 ka data diya hua hai, annual cash flow ka, and here annual cost of machine, it means cash outflow is given. Okay, now A, B, C, three parts, matlab this question is divided into three parts. So first part is ignoring the time value, identify which combinations of an annual cash flow will lead to an overall negative net cash flow and determine the total probability of this occurring. Okay, so basically negative cash flow, net cash flow we have to find out, and from that we will calculate the total probability. Okay, so here see, here we are going to do the combinations. Okay, here we are going to do the combination and we will get the negative cash flow results. Okay, so here look at this, year 1 that is 10, here also 10, here also 10, so total cash flow for 3 years is 30. Okay, 10 plus 10. Okay, and these are in thousands, these amounts are in thousands, so here also we have to reduce this 3 zeros, so here we will consider 42. Okay, so 10 10 10 30 minus 42, we are getting negative. Okay, like that we have to do the combination. So first combination I got 10 10 10, and accordingly I'll write the probability also. Okay, so here we are going to solve illustration number 12, calculation of a total and joint probability, annual cash flow which is in 1000. Okay, so year 1, after that year 2, year 3 we have drawn. So first of all year 1 mein hum log ne select kiya 10, okay, and it has a probability of 0.3. year 2 mein hum log ne again select kiya 10, uska probability hai 0.1. year 3 10 and uska probability hai 0.3. okay, so just take a total of probability, just take a total of this inflows. Okay, so 10 10 10 it is 30. Okay, 30, so inflow minus outflow we are getting negative, so it's a correct. Now joint probability we are going to find out. So joint probability is nothing but first probability multiplied by second multiplied by third, so 0.3 multiplied by 0.1 multiplied by 0.3, so we are getting 0.009. Okay, like that we are going to do the combinations which will give us negative cash flow. Okay, so after that next combination will be, see, 10 10 20. Okay, so 10 plus 10 plus 20 it is 40, 40 minus 42 it is negative. Okay, so I am going to write that here 10, here also 10, and here we are going to consider 20. So here probability is 0.3 0.1, and here 0.5 will be the probability. Okay, now just take a total, 10 10 20 it is 40. Okay, now multiply by probability, so 0.3 multiplied by 0.1 multiplied by 0.5. I am finally getting 0.015. Okay. Next part. In next part, see, we will consider now this combination. Okay. So 10, 20, 10. It is also 40. Okay. 40. 40 minus 42 negative. 10, 20, 10. Okay. 10 का probability 0.3, 20 का probability 0.2 एंड अगेन वो थर्ड ईयर में का जो 10 है उसका probability 0.3. ओके सो 10, 20, 10, इट इज नथिंग बट 40. ओके 40. नाउ प्रोबेबिलिटी, जॉइंट प्रोबेबिलिटी, सो 0.3 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 0.2 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 0.3. सो आई एम गेटिंग हियर 0.018. ओके 0.018. After that, next combination we are going to decide. Next combination is 15 here and here 10, and after that here we are going to take 10. Okay, so 15, 10, 10 we are going to take. Okay, you can check by doing combinations whether it is more than 42 or less than 42. We want total less than 42. Okay, so here I got combination 15, 10 and 10. Okay, so we will just take that. ओके हियर इट इज़ 15, 10. 15 का जो प्रोबेबिलिटी है वो 0.4 है, 10 का 0.1, 10 का 0.3. ओके टोटल 10, 10, 10 और 5, इसका मतलब 35. ओके टोटल इज 35. नाउ जॉइंट प्रोबेबिलिटी 0.4 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 0.1 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 0.3. आई एम गेटिंग हियर 0.012. And now last combination, okay, last combination 20, 10, 10. Okay, so 20, 10, 10, we are going to get a total is 40. Okay, so last combination 20, 10, 10. 20 का probability 0.3, 10 का probability 0.1, again 10 का probability 0.3. Okay, now just take a total 20, 10, 10, it is nothing but 40. Joint probability 0.3 multiplied by 0.1 multiplied by 0.3. It is 0.009. Now just we will take a total. Okay, total ले लेंगे तो हम लोग को क्या मिलेगा, joint probability मिलेगा. Okay, so 0.009 plus 0.015 plus 0.018 plus 0.012 plus 0.009. So finally I am getting here 0.063. okay, this is the total. Total is 0.063. okay, so here we got the first answer. okay, first answer क्या था अपना, negative cash flow है ना, उसका हम लोग को total probability find out करना था. so total probability is 0.063 for negative cash flows. okay, now we will concentrate on this part B. okay, on the basis of a average cash flow for each year, calculate the net present value of a new machine given that the company's cost of capital is 15%. Relevant discounting factor are as follows. So basically discounting factor is also given. Okay, so calculation जो भी है वो करके दिया हुआ है, सिर्फ हम लोग को calculate करना है. okay, so हम लोग को क्या करना है, उधर net present value find out करना है. okay, so we are going to calculate the net present value. so first of all I have written the data. This data we have just copied, okay, and we are going to use that. So here we are going to take the average cash flow, because इधर बोला है कि average cash flow लेना है for each year, okay, for each year. So average cash flow के लिए सिर्फ multiply करना है, 10 multiplied by 0.3, it is 3, 15 multiplied by 0.4, it is 6, 20 multiplied by 0.3, it is 6, okay. Now we'll take a total, 3 plus 6 plus 6, I am getting here 15 as a total. Now 10 multiplied by 0.1, it is 1, 20 multiplied by 0.2, it is 4, 30 multiplied by 0.4, it is 12, 40 multiplied by 0.3, it is 12. So just take a total, 1 plus 4 plus 12 plus 12, I am getting here 29 as a total. Okay, so 29. After that, next 10 multiplied by 0.3, it is 3. 20 multiplied by 0.5, it is 10. 30 multiplied by 0.2, it is 6. Just take a total, 3 plus 10 plus 6, 19. I'm getting total, that is 19, okay? After that, we are going to use this average cash flows, okay? So, average cash flow is 15, 29 and 19. We are going to use here. So, here we are going to use 15, which is in 1000, okay? Here, due to space, we have reduced that 00, okay? Because this is also given directly in the question. So, here I am writing full, that is 29,000 and here 19,000, okay? Now, just apply PV factor, 15,000 multiplied by 0.8696. This is given in the question in that box, okay? So, here 13,044 I am getting, 29,000 multiplied by 0.7561, full round off, 21,927. Now last one, 19,000 multiplied by 0.6575, I am getting here 12,493. Now just take a total, okay, just take a total. This is my total, that is present value of cash inflow. Total inflow ka total hum log ne liya hai 47,464. Okay, inflow minus outflow is, this is nothing but net present value. So my outflow is 42,000, okay, which is already given in the question. Okay, so just deduct this, we'll get a net present value of rupees 5,464. Okay, 5,464. We'll just check the answers. This is the first part answer, which is correct one. Now we will check the second part answer. Okay, second part answer here. 5,464. Only rupees 1 difference is there. That is okay. Now last part we are going to calculate. C part. Okay. Analyze the risk inherent in this situation by simulating the net present value calculation, okay? You should use the random numbers given at the end of a illustration in a 5 sets, okay? These are nothing but a random numbers of a cash flows. On the basis of your simulation results, what is the expected net present value and what is the probability of a new machine yielding a negative net present value? So basically we have to use the simulation technique here. So we are going to find out the range from this data, okay? Using this data we are going to find out the range, okay? So here we have written the data. Now we will find out the cumulative probabilities. See, here we have found the cumulative probability. So first is 0.3, then 0.3 plus 0.4, it is 0.7, and 0.7 plus 0.3, it is nothing but 1. So now we are going to find out the range. So start with a 0 0, and here 3 is there, right? So 3 is there, so reduce one number, so here 2, okay? Then 3 to 6, and here 7 to 9, okay? 7 to 9. After that, next part, here also we have copied the information. Now cumulative probability, okay? Here just I am taking total, nothing more than that, okay? Next is range, okay? Now from 0 we are starting, and here it is 1. So 1 se 1 kam karenge to 0 hi reh jayega, okay? So 1 se 1 kam, we are reducing 1 from 1, so we are getting 0. Now next range is 1 to 2, here 3 to 6, and here 7 to 9, okay? I hope you are getting me, okay? Don't confuse in this range. Now next part. Next is cumulative probability. Third year mein, here total is 8, okay? And here total is 1, okay? So here 0 to 2, 3 to 7, 8 to 9, okay? This is my range. Now we will go for set wise calculation of a net present value, okay? So here look at the sets. set 1, set 2, set 3, set 4, set 5. Okay, like that we are going to use. So here I am using set 1. So these are my random numbers. Okay, year, first of all year, after that random number, that is 4, 2, 7. Okay, then we will find out the cash flow using these random numbers, multiplied by P factor, then discounted cash flow will get, and then reduce the cash outflow. Okay, cash outflow was 42. That is 42,000, but here we are using 42 only, and then we'll get a net present value. Okay, so let's start. See, here random number is 4. Okay, random number is 4 in case of year 1. Okay, so this is the data for year 1. Random number is 4. 4, 4, 4 means here annual cash flow will be 15. Okay, so 15. Year 2, matlab ye table, year 2 mein random number is 2. So year 2 mein random number 2 matlab annual cash flow will be 20. Okay, 20. Like that we are using the data. Now last, that is year 3. Year 3 mein 7 random number. Okay, 7 random number here, and cash flow will be 20. Okay, so here cash flow will be 20. Now just use the PV factor. Use the PV factor. 15 multiplied by 0.8696, I am getting 13.044. After that 20 multiplied by 0.7561, I am getting 15.122. 20 multiplied by 0.6575, I am getting 13.15. Just take a total, 13.044 plus 15.122 plus 13.15, I am getting here 41.316. From that we are going to reduce the present value of cash outflow. Cash outflow is 42. Okay, 42 minus karenge, so it is minus 0.684. 0.684 is my first net present value. Okay, net present value. After that, same way we are going to calculate for a set 2. So set 2 ka random number hai 749. Okay, year 1. Year 1 mein 7 number. So here annual cash flow will be 20. Year 2 mein 4th number, that is annual cash flow will be 30. After that year 3 mein 9 number. So annual cash flow will be 30. Annual cash flow will be 30. Okay, 30. Now just apply PV factor. 20 multiplied by 0.8696, it is 17.392. 30 multiplied by 0.7561, it is 22.683. 30 multiplied by 0.6575, it is 19.725. Now just take a total, 17.392 plus 22.683 plus 19.725. So it is 59.80. Just minus cash outflow. Outflow was 42. Okay, so outflow was 42. I am getting here 17.8 is my net present value. Now set 3 ka random number hai 684. So 684, year 1 mein 6 number yahan pe aata hai, 6 number. So annual cash flow is 15. Year 2 mein 8 number hai, so 8 number matlab ye last wala, it is 40. And year 3 mein 4, year 3 mein 4 number idhar aata hai, so cash flow is 20. Okay, cash flow is 20. Abhi multiply karna hai PV factor se. So 15 multiplied by 0.8696, it is 13.044. Next is 40 multiplied by 0.7561, it is 30.244. 20 multiplied by 0.6575, it is 13.15. Just take a total, 13.044 plus 30.244 plus 13.15, total is 56.438. Just reduce your outflow, that is 42. So we are going to get a net present value, that is 14.438. 14.438. Okay, साइमल्टेनियसली यू कैन चेक द आंसर फ्रॉम टेक्स्ट बुक. ओके, देयर मेथड आई थिंक देयर टेबल इज डिफरेंट बट आंसर्स आर सेम. ओके, आई थिंक दिस इज बेटर. मीन्स आई वॉज अंडरस्टैंडिंग फ्रॉम द स्टडी मटेरियल फर्स्ट टाइम बट आई वॉज नॉट गेटिंग देयर टेबल. सो दैट्स वाई इट इज बेटर, दिस फॉर्मेट इज बेटर. ओके, सेट वाइज फॉर्मेट इज बेटर अकॉर्डिंग टू मी. सो हियर सेट 4 का रैंडम नंबर एंड सेट 5 का रैंडम नंबर गिवन है. सो सेट 4 का रैंडम, सेट 5 का रैंडम. ईयर वन में फिफ्थ नंबर, ईयर वन में फिफ्थ नंबर 15. 15 इज माई कैश फ्लो. ओके, आफ्टर दैट ईयर टू एंड ईयर थ्री में 0, 0. ईयर टू में 0 है 10 और ईयर थ्री में 0 है 10. ओके, सो हियर ऑल्सो 10, जस्ट मल्टीप्लाई बाय पीवी फैक्टर. ओके, सो 15 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 0.8696 इट इज 13.044. 10 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 0.7561 इट इज 7.561. 10 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 0.6575 इट इज 6.575. ओके, 6.575. जस्ट टेक अ टोटल, 13.044 प्लस 7.561 प्लस 6.575 इट इज 27.18. सो रिड्यूस यूअर कैश आउटफ्लो, वी आर गेटिंग 14.82 विच इज इन माइनस. ओके, सो माइनस 14.82. नाउ लास्ट पार्ट, दैट इज रैंडम नंबर्स आर रिटर्न. ईयर वन में 0 है, सो ईयर वन में 0 इट इज 10. ईयर टू में 1, ईयर टू में 1 इट इज 20 एंड ईयर थ्री में थ्री इट इज 20. ईयर थ्री में 3, 3 इज 20, इट इज 20. ओके, नाउ पीवी फैक्टर से मल्टीप्लाई करना है बस. सो 10 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 0.8696 इट इज 8.696. 20 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 0.7561 इट इज 15.122. 20 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 0.6575 इट इज 13.15. नाउ जस्ट टेक अ टोटल, 8.696 प्लस 15.122 प्लस 13.15 टोटल इज 36.968 माइनस योर कैश आउटफ्लो, वी आर गेटिंग हियर 5.035 विच इज इन माइनस. सो -5.032. ओके, सो हियर वी गॉट एनपीवी फॉर ऑल द फाइव सेट्स. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू टेक अ टोटल एनपीवी, सेट 1, सेट 2, सेट 3, सेट 4, सेट 5 का टोटल. ओके, सो सेट 1 का एनपीवी हम लोग को मिला था 0.684 विच इज इन माइनस. ओके, प्लस सेट 2 का हम लोग को मिला था 17.8, सेट 3 का हम लोग को मिला था 14.438, सेट 4 का है 14.82 विच इज इन माइनस. ओके, माइनस के लिए चाहिए तो मैं इधर ब्रैकेट डाल देती हूँ. ओके, विच इज इन माइनस. देन लास्ट वन, दैट इज -5.032. ओके, सेट 5 का -5.032. नाउ जस्ट टेक अ टोटल केयरफुली. सो हियर 0.684 विच इज इन माइनस, प्लस 17.8 प्लस 14.438 प्लस 14.82 विच इज इन माइनस प्लस 0.32 विच इज इन माइनस. सो फाइनल आंसर इज 11.702. ओके, 11.702 इफ यू मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 1000 देन इट इज 11702. ओके, सो फाइनल आंसर इज 11702. 11.702 इज नथिंग बट 11702. ओके, नाउ वी आर कैलकुलेटिंग एवरेज एनपीवी. ओके, सो हियर जस्ट आई एम राइटिंग दैट इज रुपीज 11702. ओके, नाउ टोटल एन पी वी इज रुपीज 11702 डिवाइड बाय टोटल नंबर ऑफ सेट्स, टोटल नंबर ऑफ सेट्स दैट इज 5 सेट्स. ओके सो दिस डिवाइडेड बाय 5 सेट्स. सो फाइनल आंसर इज 2340.40 भी लिखेंगे. ओके 0.40. सो यू कैन चेक द आंसर्स. सी इधर तक हम लोग ने चेक किया हुआ था. उसके बाद हियर रेंज इज गिवन. आफ्टर दैट हियर एनपीवी इज गिवन. ओके अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर फॉर्मेट दिस इज फाइनल आंसर एंड दिस इज द एवरेज नेट प्रेजेंट वैल्यू 2340.40. ओके ठीक है. सो हियर वी हैव कंप्लीटेड इलस्ट्रेशन नंबर 12.